I'm fourth generation Australian, which I look Chinese and I think I have Chinese like heritage and stuff, but fourth generation Australian, so grew up pretty much as a regular Aussie kid, I guess, from that perspective. I was always into doing different stuff, so like all the kids in primary school wanted to play soccer or rugby or something, and I wanted to play ice hockey, so I was like, oh, I'm gonna learn how to skate and join an academy and I'd go do that, so that was kind of weird. I didn't really think that much about, money or success or anything like that as a younger person, but I did like to do cool things. So, in university, we really liked cars, doing our cars and stuff, and we discovered a passion for going to the racetrack and driving cars around, right? But then we went once and it was $250 a day. I'm like, oh, can't afford this. So we put all our money into a pot and we hired out the whole racetrack, and then we sold enough tickets to other people to go to the racetrack that we didn't have to pay for ourselves. So in terms of wanting to do stuff that is sort of different, that was something that's pretty.
Okay. Were your parents entrepreneurial?
My dad's a little bit entrepreneurial, I'd say. He's been part of businesses and starting them and stuff like that, whether with friends or in a professional sense. But I would say not necessarily, no.
Yeah, okay. So maybe not the typical Asian upbringing where, you had to learn an instrument and you had time for parents to force you to study and all that kind of stuff.
My mum still made me do my times tables when I was 3 years old or something. I remember doing times tables. I was the king of times tables in primary school. It's hey, I don't know how to do times tables that well. So, a little bit of that kind of, there was a little bit of that. Definitely studying was important and stuff like that. But.